props and the audience. Now, I'm not wearing any makeup, but we do, in fact, have everything else backstage, so I said we get the show started with a number from the 2002 Tony Award winner for Best Musical, Thoroughly Modern Millie. In Forget About the Boy, the women from Treble Choir sing about the perils of love. They express their desire to discontinue their relationships with the men in their lives by cutting the cord and pulling the plug. Let's hear from Treble Choir, featuring Bridget Farhat, Maria Fiorillo, Abby Hampton, Casey Johnson, Alexis Lawton-Magross, Elena Petrovich, Maya Shankar, Becca Smith, Mary Claire Tice, Emily Tinney, Megan Gorse, and Alexa Walkwitz. The song also features tap dancers Maddie Brady, Emma Fowler, Maya Shankar, and Emily Tinney.
Comes crawling on the molly.
The production featured some of Hazlitt's biggest up-and-coming talent, including Marcus McGuire as Charlie Brown, Lindsay Manson and Nick Angel as Lucy and Linus Van Pelt, respectively, and an incredibly handsome mustachioed young man as their yet innocent, overall-wearing brother, Rira. But really, who remembers names? It was me. That's why I said that. I did it. I had this big three-word solo in the final number, climbing a tree. It shows anyone can get here, right? Yeah? Tonight, we'd like to pay tribute to this fantastic show and its amazing director, Mrs. Valla, by recreating the scene where our favorite Peanuts characters are given an assignment to discuss Beatrice Potter's classic, Peter Rabbit, using at least 100 words. Composer Clark Gessner vividly portrays four different approaches to doing homework. I guarantee you I've tried them all. And when in doubt, I guess go with Linus, but you can pick your favorite afterwards, I suppose. In doing this, Clark Gessner illustrates four distinctly different personality types. Hopefully, you'll be able to identify with one or all of them. Please enjoy the book report.
Rabbits.
about. To the harsh conditions which continually barrage the seaside building. Throughout the deceptively up-tempo song, the haunting lyrics which keep repeating are, "And the waves crashing around me, the sand slips out to sea, and the winds that blow remind me of what has been and what can never be." Here are my great friends Patrick Harney and Melody Stokosa, who will sing for you The Lighthouse's Tale.
Thank you. American musical theater. Today, The Sound of Music is performed by thousands of community and high school theater organizations each year. And every year, it is still really long. Really long. I mean, you can only be stuck in the Alps for so long, right? That's how I feel. Anyway, 16 Going on 17 is remembered by most from the 1965 Academy Award-winning movie adaptation. In our scene, freshman Quinn Rulison and sophomores Caleb Jarvis and Jordan Walling offer a more modernized version of the song. Washington Senators baseball team. He trades his soul for a chance to help his favorite team win the pennant. Granted his request by the devil, Joe shows up at the ballpark with newfound skills and the team's standing begins to improve. Gloria, a reporter covering the sports beat, praises Shoeless Joe from Hannibal, Missouri as the Senators' great newfound treasure. Tonight, senior Sam Stein will play Gloria and varsity choir will represent the Washington Senators baseball team. Please enjoy Shoeless Joe from Hannibal, Mobile.
Smoke.
Shoeless Joe from Hannibal, Mo.
Strong as the heart of the mighty.
every time. I think, I don't know, can anyone help me? Anyone willing to, don't everybody have your at once? Come on, we can just pass out. Rachel, you're back there.
Yeah?
Hey, Rachel Weiner, everybody, come on. So I've decided that next year I'm just going with my mom. She loves me, she'll go. She already agreed, actually. She was here last night and it was awkward. Anyway, Abby Burnett is here to sing a song about a similar predicament. In this scene from the 1957 Broadway smash The Music Man, Marion the librarian confesses only to herself that she is in love with Harold Hill. Halfway through the piece, she is accompanied by the school board barbershop quintet made up of Nick Angel, Brian Martell, Natish Pawa, Aaron Petrovich, and Sam Welch. Here is Will I Ever Tell You and Light a Rose.
Dream of now, dream. Bravely tell you, but only when we dream.
ladies and gentlemen, this evening marks the end of a 13-year journey through public education for our seniors. I use the term journey loosely, for some people's journeys are smoother than others, but it mostly comes down to the teachers you have. We're very blessed to have some of the greatest educators in the world teaching right here in Haslam. But of course, it only takes that one person to screw it all up. I remember this one time I had this bald guy who was crazy about singing. I won't bore you with the details. But I'm pretty sure the seniors are glad to get rid of him. It's a hunch. Anyway, this concert is in fact the last curricular event our seniors will participate in before their graduation on Sunday. Here to sing about the perils of high school, the joy of graduation, and the anticipation of looking ahead to college is Paul Marvin. Paul will accompany himself on the guitar. Singing backup for Paul is fellow graduate Lindsay Manson. Let's listen to Seniors Blues.
Well, I'm just a poor senior, and I don't like homework, but I don't mind the girls at all.
From nothing. When I started, you come and get me.
No, until I come and get him.
Until you come and get him, we're not to enter the room.
No, I want you to stay in the room and make sure he doesn't leave.
And you'll come and get him.
Right.
Well, we don't need to do anything apart from just stop him from entering the room.
No, leaving the room.
Leaving the room, yes.
Right.
If...
Yes, what is it? It's quite simple. I just want you to stay in here and make sure he doesn't leave the room, all right?
Right. Oh, I remember. Can he leave the room with us?
No! I just want you to keep him in here.
Oh, well, yes, obviously, but if he were to leave and
just keep him in here.
Until you or anyone else.
No, not anyone else, just me.
Just you.
Get back. Right.
Right. We'll stay here until you get back.
And make sure he doesn't leave.
What?
Make sure he doesn't leave.
What, the prince?
Yes, make sure he doesn't leave.
Yeah, right. I thought you meant him. Seems a bit now having to guard him since he's a guard.
Is that clear?
Yeah, quite clear, no problems.
Right. And where do you think you're going?
We're coming with you.
No! I want you to stay here and make sure he doesn't leave the room.
Oh, I see, right.
What's for?
Shut your noise, you! And get that suit on! And no singing! Oh, go get a glass of water!
Supersonic means we didn't try to brag, cause FWE is just too clean. Now, baby. Baby, don't you know that our rhymes are so biotic? Don't listen too hard. Don't be
Originally intended with breaks for the actors in mind, intermissions have become an opportunity for the audience to socialize, purchase and consume refreshments, or use the facilities. Different methods are used to signal to the audience that they should return to their seats. The traditional methods are to flash the house lights several times and to have a person walk about the lobby signaling with a small handheld percussion instrument. We will employ both methods this evening. The handheld percussion instrument will be covered by Melody Stokosa. Melody, can you come out with a small handheld instrument? So the audience in the lobby can... Now it's smaller, right? Thank you. I'm also going to ask Joanna Henry, our light board operator, to show us what the flashing lights look like so you know what to look for. When she does it, I want you to all turn around, wave, and say, thank you, Joanna. Thank you, Joanna. Wave, give her a wave, give her a wave. She's awesome. Yeah, thank you, you guys rock. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we're all set for a short break. I'll see you back here in 10 minutes.
We're going to pause in our show just a minute to tell you a little story. About 20 years ago, Haslett High School, actually Haslett Public Schools made, in my opinion, one of the wisest decisions they ever made in terms of hiring excellent educators. No, it was not me. No, it was Dishnar. And, watched Mrs. Schnarr go from actually being hired part-time teacher, part-time secretary, to full-time teacher, language arts at the middle school, and then some high school, and then AP English, and it is truly amazing how many of our young people she has affected over those 20 years. She instills a love of literature in kids. She instills a love of learning. She creates pathways for them, and she has done truly an exemplary job of championing education in our district and indeed throughout the world, because our young people go forth now with the knowledge they've gained from her and share it with others. I could go on and on about how amazing she is. She's an inspiration to the rest of the staff. She She's an inspiration to so many kids. All you have to do is go down into her room and look at the board of graduating seniors to know just a smidgen of who she's affected. And so she and I have this this song that we absolutely love. It's from the musical Candide. It's such an amazing song because it talks about, the words are, we're neither poor nor wise nor good. We'll do the best we know. And it's about living in this community and creating, doing the best we can to create the best life we can for each other and for our community. Karel and I would like to invite Mrs. Schnarr, please, if you could, up on stage. I understand that earlier today you were singing to some of your kids, your students, as a way to say goodbye. What a terrific gift. We would like to sing for you.
Let's get the show rolling once more. But before we do, I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge our amazing pit. Please help me to thank, at the Steinway, the lovely and extremely talented Georgia Fregato. On synthesizer, the incredible Beth Grimshaw. On keyboards, the amazing Rhonda Hamilton. On bass, the incomparable Chuck Page. On guitar, a graduate of the Hazlitt Choral Program, a gifted guitar player, and my good friend, Mr. Casey Vandenberg. And on drums, the outstanding Mr. John Stopper. The great Ernie Harwell once said, "If I walked back into the booth in the year 2025, I don't think it would have changed much. I think baseball would be played and managed pretty much the same as it is today. It's a great survivor." This enduring quality is recognized in the 1998 Broadway musical Ragtime. Composer Stephen Flaherty and lyricist Lynn Ahrens address the timelessness of going to a ballgame in this next scene. Here, Aaron Petrovich plays a father who solemnly and formally introduces his son to the great American pastime. Unfortunately, he is thwarted by the fans in the stands. The son is played by a terrific up-and-coming talent in the choir program, seventh grader Ben Ebert, and the fans in the stands will be played by Men's Corral. Please enjoy What a Game.
Pitcher's name is Hubbard Doo. Check the priest now.
1974, Studs Terkel wrote a book entitled Working. People talk about what they do all day and how they feel about what they do, which became the basis for the 1978 Broadway musical simply entitled Working. The show only ran for 24 performances, but has become a staple for high schools and community theaters across the country. This terrific musical has endured many revisions and is, in fact, currently enjoying a brief run at Chicago's Water Tower Place before it heads to Los Angeles next week and then back to Broadway. In the song Millwork, Michelle Daniels, Katie Mann, Caitlin Miller, and Melody Stokosa sing about the perils of working in a factory, the tedium of the daily grind, and the lives they feel they've wasted. Let's listen to Millwork from the musical Working. Sang Seniors Blues, last night was the seniors' last school night. Today was their last day of school, and on Sunday they will graduate, and soon they will be off to college. Good riddance. Just kidding. In this next song from the off-Broadway show, John and Jim, senior Marcus McGuire sings about the process of packing up and heading off to college. Please enjoy By Room. Liz's voice was beautifully innocent as she sang Somewhere Over the Rainbow, and wonderfully mature when she sang Home. In Moonshine Lullaby from the musical Annie Get Your Gun, Liz displays both characteristics within her range. Singing the cowboy chorus with Liz will be Jeremy Burton, Neil Dietrich, Tyler Durr, Michael Garnett, Caleb Jarvis, Jordan Molling, and Epi Zenker. Let's enjoy Moonshine Lullaby.
Behind the hill, there's a busy little still where your puppy's working in the moonlight. Your loving paw isn't quite within the law, so he's hiding there behind the hill. Bye-bye.
Behind the hill, there's a busy little
2007, the musical Spring Awakening opened to rave reviews. The show won 8 Tonys and has been lauded as the rock musical of this century. In the song, My Junk Is You, concert choir sings about the emotional frustrations teenagers through the ages have endured. The song speaks specifically about the emotional tumult of being enamored with someone. Let's listen to concert choir with soloists Sierra Bain, Jade Brayton, Jamie Brink, Sierra Dove, Caleb Jarvis, Jenna Obersky, Joel Reynolds, Emily Stoll, and Maggie Turney. Here is My Junk Is You.
In the midst of this nothing, this mist of a life, still there's this one thing just to see you go by. Try and just kick it, but then what can I do? We've all got our junk, and my junk is you. See us winter walking after the storm. It's chill in the wind, but it's warm in your arms. We stop all snow blind. May not be true. We've all got our junk, and my junk is you.
Have to excuse me, I know it's so wrong. I love when you do stuff that's rude and so wrong.
I go up to my room, turn the stereo on, thinking of you in the you of some song.
Everyone's favorite part of the evening, audience participation time. I know, right? Okay, so I'm just gonna ask a couple questions. If you know it, shout it really loud. Thank you. What movie is the song Danger Zone from?
Top Gun.
That's it. What movie is the song I'm All Right from?
Daddy Shack.
Daddy Shack it is. What movie is the song Footloose from? What, I can't hear you. Get it, it's funny. Kenny Loggins has written these and several hit songs in the past 30 years. Here to sing his hit song from 1972 is Sam Welch and Epi Zenker, with timely interjections provided by Paul Arvin. Here is Your Mama Don't Dance.
Your mama don't dance. Rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. When evening rolls around and it's time to go to town, where do you go? To rock and roll. The old folks say that you gotta end your day by 10. If you're out on a date and you bring it home late, it's a sin. Just say no excuse and you know you're gonna lose and never win. I'll say it again.
And it's all because
your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. Your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll. When evening rolls around and it's time to go to town, where do you go? To rock and roll.
Thank you.
line, and then a guy says,
"Get out of the car, long hair."
Ooh-wee, you're coming with me, the local police.
And it's all because
your mama don't dance and your daddy don't rock and roll.
And I guess that just goes to show you that that's what this choir program does. Either your hair turns gray or it falls out.
I love you, Wong and Man.
It's rare to hear the song Lily's Eyes sung in a high school setting. Not just because it is from the highly artistic and technically difficult musical The Secret Garden, but because this particular song is one of the most vocally demanding songs within the entire musical theater genre. Lily's Eyes takes not one but two world-class voices to tell the story of two brothers, both in love with the same woman. The woman in question is Lily, who is deceased, but whose niece bears her striking resemblance. Here, Christian Johnson and Nick Angel sing the roles of dueling brothers Archibald and Neville Craven. Let's listen to Lily's Eyes.
Strangely quiet, but now the storm simply rests to strike again. Standing, waiting, I think of her. I think of
strange
her.
This Mary, she leaves the room yet remains. She lingers on.
From death she cast a spell. All night we hear her sighs, but now a girl has come who has her eyes. She has her eyes. The girl has Lily's hazel eyes. Those eyes that saw him happy long ago. Those eyes that gave him life and hope he never known. How can he see the girl and miss those days?
Oh, she has her eyes. The girl has Lily's hazel eyes. Those eyes that closed and left me on my own. Those eyes I fear will never, ever let me go. How can I see the girl and miss those hazel eyes? In Lily's eyes, a castle, this house seemed to me, and I, her bravest knight, became my lady fair was she.
She has her eyes, she has my Lily's hazel eyes, those eyes that love my brother, never me. Those eyes that never saw me, never knew I longed to hold her close, to live at last in Lily's eyes.
Imagine me a lover.
I long for the day she'd turn and see me standing there. Would God had let her stay.
Alive and whole in Lily.
At just 23 years old, Adele has become one of music's brightest new vocal artists. Over the past 4 years, she has enjoyed a meteoric rise in fame, due in part to her powerful yet sultry voice. Over the same 4 years, our own Lindsay Manson has entertained Hazlitt audiences with her powerful, sultry, and amazing voice, as well as her exceptional personality. Lindsay has had memorable moments here on our stage singing Cold, Cold Heart, Realize, Suffering Till Suffrage, and No Bad News. Tonight, Lindsay completes her high school career singing Adele's 2009 hit, Right as Rain. Singing backup for Lindsay is fellow senior Jake Lantman. Take it away, Lindsay.
Who wants to be right as rain? It's better when something is wrong. You get excitement in your bones and everything you do's a game. When night comes and you're on your own, you can say I chose to be alone. So who wants to be right as rain? It's hard when you're on top, because when hard work don't pay off and I'm tired, no room in my bed as far as I'm concerned, so wipe that dirty smile off. We won't be making up. I cried my heart out and now I've had enough of love. Who wants to be riding high when you just crumble back on down? You make believe that
today, my family celebrated my grandparents' 50th wedding anniversary. Carell dedicated a whole concert just to them that included selections from earlier this year, as well as from tonight. This next song was one of my grandparents' favorites. Jake Lantman serenaded my grandparents as though he had known them for years. It was charming and borderline creepy at the same time. But my grandparents just loved it, so much so that after the concert, I lost track of how many times they said, "That Jake guy is going places." They commented frequently on how wonderful it was to see everyone grow into such wonderful singers, performers, and people. And then they would again proclaim just how great they thought Jake was. I know that once you hear it, you will feel the same. Singing backup for senior Jake Lantman is Lindsay Manson, Aaron Petrovich, and Christian Johnson. Here is If You Don't Know Me By Now.
That we've been through, you should understand me like I understand you. Now, girl, I know the difference between right and wrong, and I ain't gonna do nothing to break up our happy home. Oh, when I come home late at night, 'cause we only act like children when we argue, fuss and fight.
If you don't know me by now,
if you don't know me,
you will never, ever, ever know me.
No, you won't. No, you won't.
If you don't know me by now,
be easy to do.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Matt Sauer. May I just say it's been a pleasure being your host this evening. On behalf of all the choral students, it is my honor to say that we've had a great time performing for you, and we hope that you thoroughly enjoyed the show. The performing arts have played a significant role in our education, and we are proud to showcase the talents of so many students this evening. And now, here's the student voted best leader by his peers and the president of the choir council, Mr. Marcus McGuire. Stopping sword fighting team of Neil and Jake.
There's no business like show business if you tell me it's so.
We are led to those who help us.
Seniors, you've changed, graduates, you've changed our lives for good, all of us, mine for sure. What an amazing year this has been, thanks to your incredible leadership. Amazing music, incredible music, so much of it too, and really, really terrific things. Mrs. Val and I are just, we just want to call each of you up quickly and recognize you, and we'll do the senior slideshow. Mrs. Val was going to start.
But Samantha DeRuver has been with me for a couple years now, and she's been nothing but a role model to our younger students, and I'm so thankful for having her, Samantha DeRuver.
Oh yeah, she's coming all the way down, and while she does, I'm gonna have Mrs. Bella be my flower passer-outer, if you would, please. This next senior is a wonderful senior. Corelle, you heard her sing earlier tonight. She has the most sweet voice, perfect for the solo. She sang Abby Burnett. This next senior, a young man who is just a hard worker, wonderful singer, and a quiet leader, fabulous young man, Neil Dietrich. And I'm going to fess up because I missed somebody already. I'm going to put on my glasses. A wonderful soprano that you heard earlier this evening as well. Gorgeous voices, Dorothy Liz Albrand. Another great quiet leader who is hand in hand with Neil. They came in together. I'll always think of them as great friends and great leaders of this program. Jake Drummond. This next senior moved away for a while when he was a little younger, but we're so glad he moved back. We never want, well, we know he's going to move away now, go to college. But so we're so glad he was here. That is Tyler Durr. This next one is a great second soprano, one of the anchors in this section, a really, really fine singer, Molly George. You heard this next gentleman earlier this evening, truly a world-class voice, one of the top 15 singers in the state last year, exceptional, exceptional tenor, Christian Johnson. Another truly amazing tenor, sings all genres so beautifully, and just an excellent, excellent singer, Jake Lampman. Next young lady is a wonderful soprano, studies privately, and I don't know if she's ever had a big old solo, but she sure does have an amazing voice. Mostly she likes to just sing on the team, which is great because choir's a team sport. We're so glad she did. Meg Lubis. Our choir council librarian, a great leader, a young man. I'm so glad stuck in choir. He's got such a great sense of humor and leads the class fabulously. Alex Mallory. Beautiful, beautiful soprano who's headed to Eastern Michigan University to major in vocal performance, Katie Mann. An amazing pop singer, an amazing Broadway singer, an amazing classical singer, the president of the choir council, and one of the finest young women to lead our program, Lindsay Manson. Deep resonant voice, you heard him earlier tonight, Paul Marvin. Our co-president, leader of choir council and of the choir program, also a wonderful musician, headed Michigan State University to major in music education. He'll have an incredible program someday, Marcus McGuire. An exceptional flautist and an exceptional alto anchor in our section for many years, both in chorale and in select women's ensemble, Caitlin Miller. Caitlin is headed to Central to be a music major. A wonderful, wonderful singer and fabulous alto in both concert choir and chorale, Andrea Mobley. Fabulous singer, one of the busiest kids I've ever witnessed, and a really, really great scatter we learned earlier this year, Kelsey Panter. A young man I'm so proud of because he remained in choir even though the schedule didn't exactly work for him to stay in chorale this year, but he sang in concert choir and was a fabulous leader in there, really great guy, David Sheets. A terrific actress, a really wonderful, quick and dry wit, kind of reminds me of Kristen Wiig, just really fabulous, and Samantha Stein. I'm jumping back up because even with glasses, I can't do it anymore. And I apologize to this next young lady because she's a wonderful, wonderful soprano, beautiful, beautiful voice, and has done the national anthem for us a lot, which is really great because she's exceptional. Carlina Kelly. A beautiful young woman, a great alto, most positive attitude, a quiet leader. But I'll always, always think of this next senior when I see the color purple. Her name is Tanisha Thompson. Oh, another wonderful leader in our program and also of the cheer team and also in our school, a really, really terrific young woman, Chelsea Tinney. Next young man is a leader on our team, a leader on the lacrosse team, a leader on the football team, and just a really, really fine young man, Alec Hoplack. And we'll cue up that senior slideshow while I get ready to introduce our last senior, an amazing musician. Has the ability not just to play the piano, but to accompany as well. You just heard her do it. Really fabulous young woman, Effie Zinker. Seniors, come in.